you know, if you're not rigid.
Well, no, aborigine don't mean you Moorish. You gotta qualify it. We always gotta qualify. Oh, shucks.
Industrious.
That's somewhere. Tired. Y'all gonna stop getting me out the bed. Y'all gonna stop getting me out the bed. Just gonna see. Let's see if I can be with you. So if my head's chopped off, I am head chopped off. Because ain't nobody gonna tell me my head's chopped off.
A little bit.
It's chopped off? It's not. My head's chopped off?
As far as you're close. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so I'm here.
No, but you can see your face though.
I can't see it on here. Y'all see? What the hell? They be playing with me, y'all, on this Facebook. Maybe there's somebody? Okay. Well, that's not the same one. I wanted to be up on the live so I can see comments. There we go. I don't know why this system likes playing with me. I'll put it over here so I can see it. And make sure I'm not. Look. Can y'all see everything in? Is the board cut off? Because it's trying to say the board's cut off over there.
No, not here.
The board's not, looking from here. Everything is on there.
The board's not cut off. Alright, a little cold.
That might be cut off because of the percentage of what you have your screen as.
Oh. Yeah.
Might need to take the percentage down some. But, I mean, you know, you're good. Like, from here, you're good.
It's a lot more.
It's a lot.
Can I tell y'all I am exhausted today? Probably because I went running today. Y'all know I was at the track. I'm gonna put this up here. Islam Wars. So that's the donation. If you want to send donations to support your government while we support you in reclaiming your vast estate. Islam. And I'm going to start with chapter 25 of the Holy Covenant of the Asiatic Nation. And I'm going to start this every time we have class, because you have to realize if you are not in alignment with your culture, your people, you are violating your own covenant. Ignorance of the law is no excuse. So just because you don't know that you're a Moor doesn't give you any excuse for violating the supreme laws of the land. Islam. There's another one that I wanted to read after I read that one, but let's see if I can locate it. Okay. Chapter 25 of the Holy Covenant of the Asiatic Nation. I don't like this screen. It's acting so stupid. Oh, there we go. That's better. See? It just acts stupid. So anyway, A holy covenant of the Asiatic nation. I don't want to be too close. Can y'all see my head? Do I got to push it back?
No, you're good right there.
Ye are the children of one father, provided by his care, and the breast of one mother hath given you suck. Let the bonds of affection therefore unite thee with thy brothers, that peace and happiness may dwell in thy father's house. And when ye separate in the world, remember the relation that bindeth you to love and unity, and prefer not a stranger before thy own blood. If the brother is in adversity, assist him. If thy sister is in trouble, forsake her not. So shall the fortunes of thy father contribute to the support of his whole race, and his care be continued to you all, and your love to each other. I read this constantly, I post this constantly, because Moors have to realize that when you're outside of alignment, when you're not docked in your harbor, let's say, which is through nationality, you're violating this holy covenant. And a lot of people are violating them in ways of so-called these. J-O-B. Did that look like a J to y'all?
Islam.
I called you. Where's your consort?
She's on her way.
I called her this morning.
Yeah.
I was like, I was got trying to get her identification. Islam. Her identification card done. And I was like, she gonna be mad because her consort's is done, but hers ain't done. Cause I could not find. Cause y'all didn't do everything at the same time.
I know. What we did?
No, you didn't. And I know that because yours is 687,
right,
and hers is 865 or 56.
Right, right.
That's like 100 people
mine
in between.
Yep.
No.
Okay.
I'm gonna work on both of y'all's today.
Me and Evan.
Okay.
And we'll meet or I'll have them next week.
All right.
To give them to y'all, especially if y'all local. Islam. So we actually just went over chapter 25 of the Holy Covenant of the Asiatic Nation, and we're not going to just talk about it. We're going to get to property possession. Oh, what's that? Is that the Messiah? Ooh, how you get the fresh off the press?
Abdullah,
how many did you get?
200.
Oh, I ain't get mine yet. How you get yours? Masonic gate, y'all. We got the Masonic gate. I got my, look at this, y'all. Masonic gate. You jealous? Masonic gate. Islam. We're going to have those. You know what? It's so funny that, because I had necklaces, charms that Amor made in the POW. Look, where you been? You went to the beach or something?
No.
You was outside chilling in the sun. What was you doing?
Cut grass.
There you go. That'll do it. That'll give you the kiss of the sun. Looking beautiful. Anyway, so verse 1, it says, ye are the children of one father, provided by his care, and the breast of one mother has given you suck. What does that mean, y'all?
Lord's the father.
That means what? If one mother gave us all suck, that means what? We all related, right? We're all a part of the same nation, all come from the same mother, the same Stargate birth, all of us. Ain't that some crazy stuff, right? That's crazy. It's not crazy. It's beautiful because the realities are, we think that just because my mother birthed me through this Stargate over here, your mother birthed you through this Stargate over here, but the mother that birthed all of civilization birthed us all. And we all come from her. And because we all come from her, we are all brothers and sisters, is the point I'm trying to make. And this covenant is so important because when we go and separate on the land, off the land, where does it say that at? It says that specifically. And when ye separate in the world, remember the relations that bindeth you to love and unity, and prefer not a stranger versus our own blood. How are some of the ways that we, one, forgot that we were all a tribe. We all belong to the same tribe because we come from one mother who gave us all suck. So we're all one, united. But yet, through the years of separation and us going here and there, we kind of forgot that. We kind of forgot the fact that we all belong to the same Stargate that came here before anybody else came here. Islam, and we started to prefer strangers before our own blood. How do we do that? What are some of the ways that we prefer a stranger versus our own blood? That was open for, you know, people to start talking.
Being Negroes and Queens.
What does stranger mean? Maybe we should start with that. Where did you go? What does stranger mean? Anybody know through Edimon anything to give us what is a stranger? Because we know we are brothers and sisters. So wouldn't a stranger be everybody else?
Something foreign.
So I would say Albion's, foreigners, corporations, and in our JOBs, right? So we think that because we might work in a JOB, that we give this way more validity through this because one thing you have to recognize, you don't have a choice. That is a corporation. The United States that you are thinking is a so-called government is not. It's not a government. It's not a government. They don't make laws. They can't enforce them. The only thing they can do is create a whole bunch of propaganda for you to identify this way because of your ignorance, as well as you not being dry docked. And I'm gonna use that a lot. And how are you, we gotta realize a vessel. This is a vessel. This is a vessel, you're a vessel. And vessels belong to something. So if you're out in the sea, right? If you're like a boat, I can't even draw a boat, I'm not even gonna try, okay. You're a boat. Let's see, and you're in the water, and you're floating. Let's say you're floating, right? As a vessel, what anchors you? What would anchor you? I don't know if I'm spelling that right. What would anchor you? My back.
Nationality.
Nationality anchors you. There's other things that can anchor you, that can tow you in, right? The United States is claiming you right now if you don't have nothing else claiming you, right? So let's say you got two ships. I'll use bigger ships, I don't know. You got two ships. And I'm just using, I don't know what. And then you got the Maraca. And you over here, a vessel. If you don't know which one you belong to, right? And you don't state a status, right? I'm trying to connect this for you. If you're a vessel on the sea, right? And there's a lot of other vessels out there that are identified, but you're unidentified because you didn't say who you was. And if you tied yourself to this one, you claimed through your own admission to be a subject of a corporation, which means you're like this. You're like floating dead out there. You're dead. You don't exist. When you say you belong to something that's not a government, even though they may put a lot of propaganda out there to suggest that they are, which is all propaganda, because what does government actually mean? Do we know what the word government means?
In etymology,
governs, like, to supervise.
Supervise what?
Mind. Mental is mind. So, you know, government is supervision of the mind.
Are they not saying that over there? Oh yeah, they are. Okay. So government is the supervision is the governing of your mind. But if your mind and what you know is tying you to something that is not real, you're saying to the world, you cast out to sea. And if you drift, let's say, into a territory one thing we gotta realize is the USA has absolutely no geographical territory at all. None. So there's no place on the map through latitude and longitude coordinates will you be able to find the USA. You'll never be able to find it. You'll be able to find Morocco. It actually is a landmass territory, right? But USA doesn't exist. It's a corporation. It only exists on paper. So to sit here and claim to be a part of this means that your mental is governed by something that does not exist, which means you're dead, and the only thing that you can be is property.
Similar to a mortuus.
Say it louder.
Similar to a mortuus.
Yes. Dead in the eyes of the law. If you claim to be a so-called citizen of the United States Corporation, and you claim that this is your government, and you claim that you're a law-abiding citizen, and you claim that this is who represents you, you are saying to the world, I am incompetent, I don't exist, therefore, they can do whatever they want to you. So now, it's a point of who wants to buy the cargo? Who wants to buy the property? And that's where the birth certificate and the Social Security card comes in. So they'll sit here and trade you on the World Wide Web called the stock market as chattel property. And whenever they need to tap into your estate, now they go use their employees, their other individuals that are the same, in the same status, to go and get bonds. So when they pull you over, they're putting a debt on you. And they're tapping into your estate. So you never want to be a vessel without a status where anybody can come and take you. Anybody can come and take you. Because when you go into those so-called tribunals, if you make a special appearance, the first thing they see, the only thing they see, is a vessel. And the only way they will know whether or not you're trespassing or not is by the way for which you identify. What is the number way to identify yourself? What's the number way? So when you meet someone, what's the first thing you would do to identify yourself? You would do what?
Introduce yourself, your name.
Wrong.
What nation you come from?
Right? And you would say, you wouldn't say, my name is. Because a name is what?
A nom de guerre.
A nom de guerre. It's a nom de guerre. Because only corporations have names. The first thing you want to say is, I am. You're stating who you are. I am Sharon Tracy Gale Bay. So first is identity. Second is, I am Sharon Tracy Gale Bay. The Bay is the title. When you say Bay, El, Day, Ali, and Ah, that's automatically tying you to the land, even if you didn't say Moorish American National. So you start with, I am, not my name is, I am Sharon Tracy Gale Bay, Moorish American National. So now you ain't drifting. They can't claim you. You're tying yourself to the land. Islam? So it's kind of like when they say you're drifting, right? And then all of a sudden you say, I am Sharon Tracy Gale Bay, Moorish American National. Now they got to go away. They can't do anything, right? Because they can only dock lost or dead cargo. If you've ever watched any movies, I've watched many, when you see salvage vehicles, think of that as a salvage vehicle. When you see salvage vehicles out there on the out in the open sea. They're looking for lost cargo, unclaimed property. And what is the one thing they can't do if they get onto that, like, say they found a drifting liner, anything, a drifting boat. They get on there, it's like 1,000 bars of gold coin. If someone's alive on that ship, they can't claim it as abandoned or salvageable property because it belongs to someone. But if that someone doesn't say who they are, they belong to no one. You're trespassing. And punishable based on whatever that so-called corporation, that so-called nation has in their laws for trespassing, right? So you never, so when you watch all these movies, why they out there sitting here patrolling the seas, looking for lost cargo, when they sit here trying, you know, I just saw on Facebook where they were talking about the so-called Titanic never sunk. I don't know if y'all seen that news flash that they're talking about now. I'm not going to worry about it, but that, let's say that the ship did sink, because you've seen many movies that talked about, okay, they hit an iceberg. I mean, we thought the story sounded kind of stupid to begin with. You done put millions and millions of dollars or notes or finance into this big ship, and you ain't paying attention on your first voyage, and you just happened to hit an iceberg and sink. Back in the day, we probably thought that was the most, oh my God, that's so tragic. But our reasoning mind and our thinking mind is saying, that is the stupidest thing that I've ever heard. If you have millions of dollars put into this so-called cargo, putting into the so-called ship, and y'all just going to hit an iceberg? That doesn't make sense. How do we even believe that? I don't know. Dorothy hit her head a little hard. That's all I can say. Because we believe that. We believe that they hit an iceberg. They only had one or two people up there looking. They had no sonar to sit here and say, oh, something about to hit. You about to hit something? We sometimes gotta think logically. But anyway, always think about this. I am only who I am. I am who I am. Nobody identifies me but me. But if you don't know who you are, and you're not sitting here stating your appellation, who you are, and you're sitting here saying that my name is Marie Saunders. My name is Marie Saunders. I reside in the state of Florida, and my residence is here. Well, you just said, I'm a vessel with a dead status, able to be sold to the highest bidder. That's literally what you said. So you can't sit here, because I talk to Moors, I talk to people who don't quite tie their camel, don't quite do the status thing. And I'm going here because before we can talk about property, possession, before you can talk about private allodial trusts, before you can even do anything, you better get the status piece overstood. So I'm going to stay here for a bit, because yesterday when I was at the hotel, everybody was telling me I couldn't see my face. And I was like, Sharon, you got to do the video all over again because we can't see it. Like, what you need to see me for? It's the board that needs to be seen. Anyway. Status. What is status? What does that mean? Does anybody have a Black's Law Dictionary? Yes.
Status. I had a definition of stranger. Good status.
You said you had a what?
The definition of the stranger.
Oh, what's the definition of stranger?
Stranger is a use with reference to the subject of subrogation. One who, in no event resulting from the existing state of affairs, can become liable for the debt and whose property is not charged with the payment thereof and cannot be sold therefore.
Bible. Are you reading Stranger?
Stranger.
Okay.
Stranger. And this is more. So by this term is intended third persons generally. In its general legal signification, the term is opposed to the word privy. Those who are in no way parties to a covenant or transaction, nor bound by it, are said to be strangers to the covenant or transaction. That's what they have. This is Black Star Dictionary, 6th edition.
Oh, that's the 6th?
6th
edition. We do 4. Six started hypothecating.
Right.
So did 5.
Sure. Yeah.
What you got for Stranger?
Darren.
Huh?
Okay. It says, as used with reference to the subject or subrogation, one who in no event resulting from the existing state of affairs can become liable for the debt and whose property is not charged with the payment thereof and cannot be sold therefore.
Hmm.
That's
right.
What we have here.
What's that? Which book is that you're reading from?
This?
Yeah.
This is Blackball.
That's 4th?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Same definition. As used with reference to the subject of subrogation. Look up subrogation and somebody else look up status.
Okay, I'll look up status.
One looks up status, one looks up
subrogation.
Subrogation.
I'll look up subrogation. Here's subrogation. Subrogation, the substitution of one's person in the place of another with reference to lawful claim, demand, or right. That's why held.
Substitution of what?
Substitution of one person in the place of another with reference to a lawful claim, demand, or right. Then it has YL versus Smith, 101 Florida, 97.134.
Read the definition one more time.
The substitution of one person in the place of another with reference to a lawful claim, demand, or right.
And what was the case law it quoted?
It's a YL versus Smith, 101 FLA, Florida, I guess.
Y-L, yeah. Spell Y-L.
W-H-Y-E-L versus Smith.
What year?
What year?
It doesn't have the year next to the case?
No. All
right.
Just say 101 FLA, 97.134.
Okay. That's a Florida case?
Yeah.
Somebody look up that decision, that case decision, if you can. I don't know. are you not paying attention? What's going on over there now?
Yeah, nah, I missed that case decision or what.
Huh?
Case decision or what.
Wild versus Smith? Oh. And what about status?
Status. Standing, state or condition. Social position.
You said standing?
State or condition. Condition. Yeah, state or condition.
Oh, I said position?
Yeah. After that. Social position. The legal relation of individual. To rest of the community. About three more paragraphs in it. This is the rights, duties, capacities, and incapacities
uh-huh.
which determine a person to a given class.
That's good.
Yep.
Status. Subrogation. Status is a standing, a state, or a condition, social position, legal relation of individuals to the rest of the community. Rights, duties, capacities, and incapacities. Put that together. Which determines a person to a given class. Look up class. Subrogation. The substitute of one person into the place of another with reference to a law or a claim, demand, or right. They do that to you all the time with subrogation.
What?
This is it? It's long.
Underneath.
Oh, we all got the decision? Oh, this is the decision?
Yeah, underneath it has something that's a little more summarized.
Okay. So they didn't have it summarized?
You look underneath. Underneath.
Text me that. I'll read it later. Or I'll post it on social media. Where was it at? Status. So, status is everything. When you state for the record, because whenever you're speaking, it's on the record, I am. When you're stating I am, you're stating your status in society. And it's also talking about what class and capacities or incapacities you might be at. So when you have an opportunity to state your status in standing, in condition, in social position, in legal relation, you're doing all of that when you say, I am. That's your title. That's your title. That's your title. I am Sharon Tracey Gale Bay. You just said your status. And even if you didn't add Moorish American National, because the Moorish American National Sovereign is answering everything in status. So one, you said, hey, my standing. I'm Sharon Tracey Gale Bay. My condition, I'm a Moorish American national. Legal relation, I'm a national and I'm a sovereign in the community. So you just stated with that, just that one status, that one statement, your rights, your duties, capacities, you're not showing any incapacities, you're showing capacities which determine your class. And your class is this. Oh, my goodness. You're stating all of this with this. Nobody has a class above you. In this society, this class, this is determining your class, your social position, your standing, your state, and your condition. Right there by just saying, I am Sharon Tracey Gale Bay, Moorish American National Sovereign at and what's the other out on the grid? I mean, you could keep going for days. With different, so you know, something might catch with a Moor or with a foreigner, but once you say I am Sharon Tracey Gale Bay, a Moorish American national, sovereign at Northwestern Maxim, North America, Morocco, you just answered all of anybody's question as to where you're docked. You could add
indigenous, aboriginal,
which people still dispute about. Autochthonous, can you spell that one?
Woo! Okay.
God, you got a computer right there. It's ace. Oh, I ain't gonna try.
I know
it's
A-U-T-O.
Why don't you just look it up instead of guessing?
I know, right?
Because
it's not gonna be in
no, just like as you put it in your Google.
Autochthon.
If you put it in your Google, it's gonna come up. Like, watch.
Autochthon. A-U-T-O.
C-H.
C-H.
What, y'all got it?
But we'll get it. All right.
All right, well, why y'all doing that?
We're going to get it. Perfection.
O-N-O-U-S.
No, a top tongue. You can put a top in this. Let's add a suffix in it. But we're going to get it.
It's long.
A top.
I need a decision. Quick decision part of it.
A-U-T-O. C-H-T-H-O-N. Autochthon.
Islam. So when you start your status, and you know who you are, can anybody subrogate you?
No, not at all.
Can anybody act like you? What are ways you can avoid that? Because when you start your, when you start with status, and we already said, by you stating this mantra, and you know we have a longer mantra, we got to find out if Fatima.
Oh, no.
Are you serious? It's 2 weeks.
Fatima is too shy.
She's too shy. Say it right there. You ain't got to get in front of the camera.
You know it.
We're gonna put her on blast next week. She's going to know it next week, y'all. She's going to know the mantra next week. Because the mantra is giving your standing, your state, your condition, your social position, your legal relation of individuals to the rest of the community, your rights, your duties, your capacities, determines your class. Did anybody look up class? So if you don't proclaim and declare your Moorish nationality, you ain't got no standing, no status. You don't have a standing and no status. They created the white, what is it called, y'all? The Christian black codes for those who don't have a status and standing at law at Morocco or any other landmass.
Can I ask you something? What is the those numbers up in the letters up there?
Can somebody explain what the numbers and the letters are up there? AA222141. Have you ever read the Clock of Destiny?
No.
Write it down and read it.
Title 20. Chapter 2, Title 22, 7141.
Anybody want to find that and read that? Oh, you got the Clock of Destiny right there. Look at you. Oh, shucks. I gotta get it. What? You gonna make me do it? You gonna make me find it? You know it's two books, right? Clock of this is volume.
Yeah, I don't think it's in there. It's on the Zodiac Constitution.
Yeah, Zodiac Constitution.
Clock of Destiny. Identification card.
It's long. It's so hot here, y'all.
I have the definition of class.
You got the definition of class?
Mm-hmm.
It's not in this one. It must be in the second.
It's supposed to be registered with the U.S. Department of Justice.
Mm-hmm.
Library of Congress.
That is you? Burning up. Burning up. All right. Amor said this to me the other day. He said, when I went into the tribunal, they demanded he take his fez off. And because he wouldn't take his fez off, they locked him up. Article 7 of the Zodiac Constitution states the following. In the Christian Union courtroom, the Moors cannot be forced to remove their red fezes from their heads, nor can they be forced to raise their hand and take an oath over the Christian Bible. Neither can Moors, the Bays, and the Ls employ white or Negro lawyers to represent them. The reason for this is that white people, and they put these in parentheses right. because they're Albions, they're modern Europeans, but they know back then when this was drafted, Moors didn't know any other way to identify the Caucasian, so they called them white person. And their Negro slaves definitely cannot represent free Moorish Americans. The Negro is the property of the Union slave holders. The Moors must respect the court by saying, "I affirm." Here, the court has no jurisdiction over them, which automatically makes them qualified to defend themselves by their Zodiac Constitution law and their mathematical number 9. The number 9 corresponds with the letter I, based on the 9 months from conception to birth, which makes you yourself the great I am. The first and the highest law of self. Of self protection.
What article was that in?
7.
7.
Circle 7. I mean, no, 7 of the Zodiac Constitution. And self preservation in harmony with your Zodiac 12 signs, unchanged constitution, moral law of the 360 degrees square from the number 9. The Moorish Zodiac Constitution is referred to in Christian mythology as the Holy Quran or Al-Quran, meaning the earth, the moon, the sun, and the 7 planets of the chronology zodiac record of the Moorish nation of the North Gate, North America. The name Mohammedan, prophet, religion, God, church, temple, mosque were established by the Dutch Anglo-Saxon priesthood Franciscan fathers of North who overthrew the Moorish Society of Islam between 1789 and the Union of 1863, y'all. And they try to tell you, y'all ain't even been enslaved that long to be acting like y'all know who y'all are.
Right.
Because it was not even 100 years. The Moors, the Bays, and the Ls must never attempt to teach or lecture in Christian institutions, namely churches, temples, mosques, schools, and hall. This is a violation of the Union Society, States' Rights, Magna Carta, Code of Mary and Christ. The truth of the Moorish Zodiac Constitution law and moral human principles definitely conflicts with the Christian Union customs and doctrine of the Magna Carta from every angle. Nor do not criticize the European people's belief in the religion of their sons and their women image. That's for them. You have your own culture. You have your own heritage. You have your own ancestral way of identifying and practicing your culture. That's theirs. Yours is yours. You can't be going over there into their union claiming to be a Christian, claiming to be a nom de guerre, claiming to be a member of their United States, a member of their stuff. You can't be it because you have your own. You're warring against your own people. You're violating the holy covenant of the Asiatic nation. And it's your responsibility. Okay, you want me to read that?
Was that what she was just reading?
No.
This is the Clock of Destiny, which everybody should have a copy of, and guess what? You can download it from Scribd.
It's in the group.
It's in the group, too. Yep, it's in the group of the file section of the Moorish American Consulate Northeast and Maxim group under Clock of Destiny 1 and 2. Just go and download it and read it. If the lawmakers of the 50 Union States Society of North America should attempt to ignore the Moorish American Zodiac law and birthrights of this Constitution, it would be an act of supreme violation of their own Magna Carta Code. Do we gotta go over to Magna Carta for y'all?
Yeah.
We really do? That ain't even ours.
It's not ours. It's a great charter for them.
But you need to know what you need to know. So you don't continue to keep violating your own laws, which is why they call you bandit, a terrorist, and an extremist, and all these things, because you're walking around acting like a black person when you have a, you have heritage, you have bloodlines, you have birthright, you have culture, you have all of these things, and you have a status, which is a standing, a state, and a condition, social position, legal relation of individuals to the rest of the community. You have that, and you're abandoning it because of ignorance. And it started with mom. Do we want to talk about mom? The basic reasons why, I don't even want to go here, but the basic reasons why Asians could never become Christians. I don't really want to go here. Because y'all be in your feelings. And we're talking actual factual law. Actual factual sin. But you're in. And it started with 1789 to 1863. And it's impossible for the people of heavy olive. Is that me? Who's that? I didn't do that, and I'm mad that I too. The clock of destiny. It is impossible for the people of heavy olive and live olive hue of skin, commonly known as dark brown light, to ever become a Christian because of this fact. The Christians worship a white son of God and his white mother, Mary, the very image of themselves. The Christian God is definitely white or ruddy pale because he only begotten son is tangible evidence. You might ask yourself this question, what chance do I have to enter the gates of the Christian heaven dominated by a white God, his son, his mother, Mary, Mother Mary? The very image of the woman who falsely cries rape, followed by son's image of the woman who falsely cried son's cross burning and lynching. Oh my God, why am I reading this? Such is the Christian nation's heaven dominated by the white woman, the god of hatred, fear, crime, and corruption. I have such issues reading this because my energy is saying y'all ain't ready to hear this, which is why I'm not ready to read this. On the contrary, there was a specific reason for the new masses of humanity referred to as white people to establish the church in false doctrine of Christ and Mary. So let us observe the reason in order that we might have a broad view which will enable us to erase the hatred against them which is now dominating our nature. We don't have to hate them. They're different from us. They have their creed. You have yours. They have their laws. You have yours. And you can't intermingle them. It has already been stated elsewhere in this book that during the past 1,367 years, there has only been two world empires, namely the Moorish Empire of the Order of Islam and the Christian Empire of the Order of Christ. One for Moors, one for Albions. During the world domination of the Moorish nation, the blonde woman of Patagonia, South America, had manifested their cultured height in a society of Islam, which qualified them to establish the society of the cross laden with mystery and emotional false doctrines as a positive weapon of liberating themselves from the amalgamated iron-handed rulers or dictators who had shielded the secrets of nature as shown in the signs of the zodiac and established a doctrine of mystery and religious superstitions by force. That's you, sons. As a result, the following amalgamated generation of Moorish fathers and blonde mothers grew up in ignorance of the science of the 12 signs of the zodiac and the applied principles of Islam, which is in turn resulted in the corruption of the society of Islam under the influence of Islamism, of various unreasonable procedures of religion, religious worship, strenuous mysterious prayers, and the restrictions of literary education in the common masses.
Raw truth.
The corrupt process of the selfish, jealous, amalgamated rulers of the Muslim world converted the Society of Islam human caste, slavery, economic and social degradation, crime, bloodshed, human destruction, from which was born the army of the mystic banner of the cross, led by militant white women, or Patagonian blondes, supported by many wise Muslim women and sons struggling for freedom, which resulted in some 364 years of intermittent conflict from Peru to Alaska and across the Pacific and the Atlantic Oceans in the Northern Hemisphere. A great battle between the two different types of religious superstitions, namely Islamism, Crossism, referred to as the great battle between the crescent and the cross, or Muhammad and the Christ, the period of crucifixion, lynching, burning, and murdering one another over ideas of impractical isms and mystery of variety, which has dominated the world for some 400 years and has manifested with the racial and color schemes of corruption. The Muslims, with their strenuous ism of mystic religious worship and superstition, are not guilty of the establishment of the race and color scheme. They are guilty of the caste system and segregation according to class and rank and method of mystic or superstitious religious worship in the institutions called mosques, from which was born the institution of worship called church, and the race and color scheme with a marriage license laws established by the Patagonian blonde woman of South America. This system prohibited the issuance of marriage license to Moorish men or women who desire to marry white women or men in North America, especially in the United States. Upon this is founded the myth of black and white people's blood, which was born out of the church system, namely the Catholics, the Protestants, the Baptists, and the jury of Jewish temples of the United States and North America. I could go on. I don't want to. And I'm gonna tell you why. Because y'all be in y'all feelings. I want to read this part. The celebrative Magna Carta of colonial North America, which granted freedom to the blonde masses en masse, French, which defines in English as one body. The celebrative Magna Carta is the document which granted economic, social, and commercial freedom and equality to all people of ruddy, pale skin with long hair or flaxen, regardless of race label and religiousism and politicalism faith. The process us, what government elect Talmadge of Georgia and Senator Bilbo of Mississippi had reference to over the Meet the Press.
What the heck?
In the celebratory story of Abraham Lincoln involving the freedom of the Moorish descendants referred to as Negroes is played up falsely. The insignia of the United States dime of 1865 represents the staff of the Roman Axe, the United White Order, which unfortunately left Moors or Asiatics descendants on the outside looking in universally during the past 93 years of Roman economic, social, commercial strife. Father Abraham, the god of the Roman Union, involving the North and the South Pole, July 4th and July 1st, Lincoln. If you are skeptical, you might denounce the names such as Negro, Colored, Black, and African American to go to the library to ask for the history of the Moorish Empire, your history, and carefully observe the white servants' reactions. This is the history of the European American, European in America has thought you would never know, because Europeans are not Americans. Nevertheless, you have the fundamentals in this book, namely The Clock of Destiny. All right, you're gonna have me reading this whole book. Oh, I want to do that.
Last on the term class.
She don't want to read that.
I don't want to read that. Okay.
Go ahead. What's class? I mean, where was that?
Because you know,
give me class.
Going all day on the clock of destiny, books one and two. And
all day on clock of destiny, because we sit here trying to identify under someone else's Magna Carta when we got our Zodiac Constitution and the Quran over here. We over here. We have our own status and standing. They have their own status and standing. You can't be a part of their union unless your property can't be. And because they would be violating if they put you in there any other way, because even though they have you as property, they know damn well you can't be in their union any other way, or it's a violation of their Magna Carta. Did you get me? You can only be a dog in their union, property, to be disposed of how they see fit. How they see fit. And I realize through all of the years of ignorance that we, that been steeped upon us through their, why do you think when you go to their educational systems, they teach you about pilgrims coming here, being here first, you coming here on this mystical slave ship 500 years ago. They can tell you whatever they want to tell you. They can educate you however they want to educate you. If they want to give you vaccinations that's going to keep you docile, they can give you vaccinations that's going to keep you docile. If they want to teach you that black people exist, they can teach you as black people exist. If they want to create museums with black people in them, they can create museums with black people in them. Because you're property. And they can do anything they want. They can have policy enforcers in their schools with guns. They can have the teachers raping the children. They can do whatever they want. Because you erred first. You are the first one in sin. Do you realize that? Do you get it? Because you sitting here identifying outside of your pedigree and your nationality, gang war with your Moors, brothers and sisters who's trying to liberate you, you're in sin. Are you understanding what I'm saying? I don't think this is complicated. I think it's quite simple.
First Amendment of the Bill of Rights.
Huh?
First Amendment of the Bill of Rights to religious freedom.
You think you got religious freedom? Really? Because that Constitution ain't written for you. That Constitution is what they supposed to be doing. That Constitution is a commercial agreement, is a commercial contract. We only in there in Article 6.
Right.
But everything else is how they are to act here. You can align however you want as sovereigns. Truly you can. You don't have to put yourself in that book, in that Constitution. It's not yours. It's a commercial agreement we established for them to do business here. Which is why we can leave them and they sitting here mad as hell. That's why they mad. Huh?
No, I was saying there's no difference between any constitution, the of or the for, just that one word.
The Constitution for the United States of America is the contract we established.
Right.
Because they like to subrogate, they created a Constitution of the United States. This is a commercial agreement within their corporation. But we got the Constitution for
right.
them.
Wow.
That's why it says for. It's for them. It's how you're going to do business at Morocco. Or we're going to take your pledge. What you pledged, which was everything. You've pledged everything, including yourselves, to get that so-called status, that classification in our society, wherever that is. Here, this is our society. This is our government. This is our land. We're the sovereigns. We gave you a classification how to be at our domicile, at our northwest of Mexico, North America, Morocco. So if you keep gang war talking about, oh, we don't recognize your status, excuse me, to not recognize our status is not to recognize the Magna Carta. And that Magna Carta is what? Didn't I just read what it said, what the Magna Carta is? I read it again. The celebrated Magna Carta. Can somebody pull the Magna Carta up? Do I gotta bring it up? is the document which granted economic, social, and commercial freedom and equality for the people of ruddy, pale skin with long hair and flagness, regardless of race, label, or religiousism and politicism faith. That was to give you stated in Magna Carta. The Magna Carta. So you would have a standing outside of being victimized and brutalized by our sons. I'm just going to say it. Because a lot of them were doing some crazy things. I ain't even gonna go there. Article 6, what? Yeah, vaccinations are poison. Of course we know vaccinations are poison. They can treat their property however they see fit. Why are you identifying as their property? You might wanna get nationality and start standing under your own status. They looking at you like, you come into their tribunals talking about my name is Elvis Presley. When you say my name is, they already know you lost at sea. And they gonna hypothecate you and take all your wealth through that. Now I'm hot as heck, y'all. Goodness gracious. What's chapter 6? He said chapter 6.
Chapter 6 or what?
I don't know. He didn't say. He just said chapter 6. So when we're thinking about the Constitution is what we hold them to. But we're not subjects, y'all. And we don't need to commerce. And we don't need to do all of these things that we think that we need to do. Article 6 of the Treaty of Peace and Friendship. This is our document. The Treaty of Peace and Friendship is what they can hold us to. And what we hold them to, and how we are to dispute when there's a so-called claim, is the Treaty of Peace and Friendship. But when there is a situation when, if they sit here trying to come to our domiciles and claim through some fake mortgages that they own the land, well, how you own the land? And through the Constitution, you're supposed to give due process. And because of the Constitution, you ain't supposed to be violating that. And there's no so-called, you can't be taking no oaths to the Constitution of the United States of America. No, it's the Constitution for the United States of America. If either of the parties, Article 6 of the Treaty of Peace and Friendship, if any more shall bring citizens of the United States or their effects to His Majesty, the citizens shall immediately be set at liberty and the effects restored in like manner, if any more, not a subject of these dominions, shall make prize of any of the citizens of America or their effects and bring them into any of the ports of His Majesty, they shall be immediately released as they will then be considered under His Majesty's protection. If either of the parties shall be at war and shall meet a vessel, well, I ain't gonna read that one. That was 5. Yeah. Article 7. If any vessel, we know vessels could be ships, anything, you're a vessel. Mm-hmm. If any vessel of either party shall put into a port of the other and have occasion for provisions or other supplies, they shall be furnished without any interruptions or molestations. They can't do nothing to y'all. But y'all got to stand on status. Why is my stuff all backwards? I don't even get it. My stuff is like all backwards. And we got to get out of the habit of getting in the subject matter. We got to get out of the habit of getting in the subject matter. What is subject matter? Matter for subjects? Subject matter? Why are you talking about subject matter? You got a status that nobody has above you. You ain't got to talk about no status. I mean, no subject matter. You ain't got to go into federal rules and procedures. You ain't got to go into court procedures. You ain't got to go into none of that. Stand on your status. Stand on you knowing the mantra. Does you know the mantra? No. Do you know the mantra, Aneb? No. Do you know the mantra?
Never saw it.
Do you know the mantra? You know it? Write it down. I want to see it written down. Write it down. You can't read nothing. Write it down. Since you don't want to say it out loud, write it down. Status. This is from Army Bay Publications. Jurisdiction. We talking jurisdiction, y'all. Status is a standing, a state or condition, social position. Legal relation of individual to the rest of the community. The rights, duties, capacities, or incapacities which determine a person to a given class. A legal, personal relationship not temporary in its nature, nor terminable at the mere will of the parties, with which third persons in the state are concerned. While term implies relation, it is not a mere relation. Jurisdiction. The word is a term of large and comprehensive import, and incapacitates and embraces every kind of judicial action. It is the authority by which courts or judicial officers take cognizance and decide cases. The legal right by which judges, but you have to be a judge, exercises their authority. It exists when court has cognizance of classes of cases involved, proper parties are present, and Islam and point to be decided is within issue. So when you challenge jurisdiction and it's not answered, not necessarily just saying it, they have to have a delegation of authority order from some competent, lawful body, Article 3, sovereign of the land. So anybody not establishing that, well, you know, the receipt, you know, whatever they're talking about is null and void ab initio. And you can ignore them as if they're not standing in front of you, because technically they're not standing in front of you, because they ain't got no standing. We got to stop going to the monkey pony shows. We got to stop it. We really do. I'm just saying. I don't like sitting here listening to what, no, I ain't even going to say that. It is the authority, capacity, power, or right to act, carry into execution, or enforce sentence, judgment, or decree, deal with general abstract questions, deal with subject matter, decide, including questions of law as well as of fact, declare, expound, administer, or apply the law, determine action, controversy, or question, do justice, do justice, enter inquiry. Identity. Evidence. Sameness, the fact that a subject, person, or thing before a court is the same as it represents claims or charge. Civilior mortuus. Civilly dead. Dead to the view of the law. The condition of one who has lost his civil rights and capacities and is accounted dead in law. Hot, y'all. I'm like burning up.
Yo, fire!
I am hot. What are you giving me? What? Why do people write so crazy and then want you to read their writing? Reek, you say it. Say it out loud. Say it out loud. I see being the...
being the person or thinking one is a person is possession. Like being possessed.
Islam. So when you go into those tribunals and you an empty vessel because you ain't docked, you ain't dry docked at with no status, they hypothecate and subrogate you. That's messed up, ain't it? But is it really messed up? Because you're supposed to know who you are. You're supposed to sit here and not be gang warring with your nation. Because we peaceful. You don't see us out there running around, blowing nothing up, shooting nobody. We just send you a lawful command. Here's my peaceful, lawful command for you to get back in honor. Here you go. Get it done. And then y'all sit here talking, oh, we paper terrorists. How can you be? What the hell is a paper terrorist? What is that? Because what is a terror? You're creating terror. You're creating fear. Can a piece of paper create fear? It can only give you facts, lies.
Paper cuts.
A paper cut? Oh, that's a terror? You gonna get a paper cut from
you,
paper?
You the one being terrorized.
Hello, right? We got people in the POW camp. We peaceful Moors on our lands, correcting the miseducation and the ignorance of the land, and you're warring against us, hypothecating, running up and down our Moroccan streets with your POW and your highwaymen vehicles that are about to be seized up, just so you know. Because you still think this is party over here by the Albions? Y'all better get it right. Y'all better get on them boats and get out of here. Those ones who have the wherewithal to do so, and the ones that don't, you better get it right. Because you are, I'm just going to say it, drifting. Moors can dry dock and anchor. They literally can anchor. If they're Negro, Black, and colored, but your butt can't anchor. How you anchoring? What are you anchoring to? You drifting and you drifting. And whoever wants to pay the bill, they gonna seize you up, salvage you, and take you over. And you keep listening. You keep listening to these people that don't care. All the big boys that left the building left you holding the bag. And you sitting there still trying to do business as usual. Not even realizing all around you is Moors. All around you. I ain't trying to make you scared or nothing like that. I'm just trying to get you to see the realities of life. And the fake, illusional security you feel is that, an illusion. Light gave me some stuff yesterday that blew my mind. Because we're about to bring some people up in here to come handle this. Where's my tablet? All right, I'm going to get out of here because I want to read something. I don't know if Light want me to read it though, but I'm going to read it anyway. It's so hot, y'all.
It's burning up out there.
I know. Y'all want to know what I said? I ain't going to say it. Should I say? I said it's so hot up there, some people might just burn up if they go outside.
That's true.
Who might
be? Well, I don't think they'll be. Wait a minute. Let me rephrase that. Some. Let's use the appropriate etymological term. Some things that think that they're human. That walk around and go get suntans, think they get suntans. If you're on the beach and you ain't got no melanin, I'm just saying, skin cancer is your body breaking down because the sun is killing you. Yes, I'm just going to say that.
That's true.
I'm just saying, like, that's just like how we got miseducated to think we black and we sit up. What you laughing at? You laughing at me? What? Did you write it down?
Right.
Did you write it all the way down? Fatima
went blank.
Is tripping today. And I'm going to blame it on the heat. But the heat's supposed to give you energy, not take it away.
I'm not tripping.
Supposed to give you energy. Oh. Energy. I say it. Y'all want me to say it? I said it like four times today already. And I say it so fast, you might miss words in between. We were talking about ships. Goodness, there was a movie called Virus. It was Jamie Lee Curtis. It had some sci-fi stuff in it. But the point was, she worked for a salvage company. A salvage shipping company. Out in sea. Claiming dead and lost cargo. Vessels. They were trying to tell y'all all types of stuff. You know, I'm going to put the big old boat on here. I'm just going to do it. Everybody got this. Yep. Status. Subrogation. If you don't have status, they're going to subrogate you. You got to get dry docked. This is how you dry dock yourself.
Don't erase it yet.
Don't erase it yet? Okay.
Noble vizier, judge, when you're ready.
Islam.
I have the
class.
Turn for class.
Go ahead. Say it out loud.
I'm more than I'm proud.
It's law, right?
Class, a group of persons, things, qualities or activities having common characteristics or attributes. The order or rank according to which persons or things are arranged or assorted. Securities having similar features. Also a body of persons uncertain in number. Class.
It's long. It said a lot. Your standing, your state, your condition, your social position, your legal relation of individuals to the rest of the community. You have the highest status, standing, and classification at Morocco. Everybody else is jealous. But they're jealous now more so because you know this now. You done remembered. You done recalled who you were. But about in 1980s, let's say 90s, they was chilling. They was chilling because you didn't know who you was. You didn't know who you was. You was identifying outside of your status, and they had no they had no right. And let's say they didn't have to acknowledge you in any way, shape, or form because you was property of someone. I'm just saying. And you are property of somebody who's property of somebody else because they property. Think about that. You property of an individual that is also property of another. Doesn't that seem ridiculous to you? Because everybody who's not anchored dry docked. And the only way you anchor dry docked at Morocco is if you're a subject or a national. Or we got treaty relations with another nation. Those are the only three ways you can be dry docked here. Outside of that, you're swimming. Hoping nobody see you swimming. Literally, when you watch these movies, you know, there was another movie that came out. I don't remember the name of it, but it was these two Albions in a boat, swimming, hoping a freighter came by to salvage them. Now, was she in bad situation, drifting by herself? Or did she become in a worse situation being claimed by somebody as cargo? That's the better question. What happens when you get claimed? You better hope those individuals that's claiming you ain't pirates. Because there's many boats and ships looking for lost cargo. And if you sit here talking about I'm a citizen of the United States of America and you don't look like us, they know damn well you lying. And they might just kill you out there. Take an organ, eat your flesh, I don't know. I'm just saying, what you learn here inside of the dominions of the Moroccan Empire ain't so true out there. Don't be caught out there and you don't have no nothing dry docking you. You don't got no, you can't lift up your Moroccan flag for aid because you got treaties with all these other nations. So when they see you, they have to anchor you to shore and help you get to where you're going. They have to do that. Treaty relations. Treaty of peace friendship. But if you put that banner up, where nobody has to listen to it anymore because you've dissolved that union, now you are cargo. Are y'all getting what I'm saying? Do I have to put a picture up there?
You did.
I did, right? Do I want to do it again? So I can push this home before we get to property possession?
Yeah, because, put it up there.
Huh?
Put it up there.
You want me to put the ship up? I can't. Who's a drawer in here? Did anybody know how to draw? All right, come on up here. You gotta draw two ships. No, draw three ships.
Three ships.
One's gonna be Moroccan. One's gonna be the U.S. the USA corporate ship, and another one's gonna be the Manchurians. Put the Manchurians. I like the Manchurians. Put the Manchurians. Or Russian. Put four of them. Put the Russian.
Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria.
Because everybody waiting for the Moors to wake up. Everybody.
Three ships.
Everybody waiting. And here's the water. Let me I can draw the water. I can draw the water. Here you go. And introduce yourself.
You ain't putting no waves up in there.
Islam, nobles. I am Tahir Rasul El Basir Bey.
Say the mantra while you up there. Let them know what that is.
Say the mantra.
Oh, you done forgot. You got to think about it. I know he don't.
Yeah,
sad. He be thinking about it when people don't know he thinking about
it. I am Tahereh Basir Bey, and appropriate persona sutras, and appropriate solo, and appropriate reddest at all times. I am a descendant of the great pharaohs of Kemet and of the Moabites and Canaanites. I am an aboriginal, indigenous, Moorish American national, and I am exercising all of my rights at this time and at all points in time. You are commanded to state your name and nationality to be read into the record for the record immediately without further comment. I am the law. I am the government. You do not have jurisdiction over me. You are commanded to set me free immediately, return my property immediately, cease and desist all actions and contact, and take and leave and never return. This is your due process of my notice of intent to lien you. If you do not do as commanded and take the leave. Notice the principal is notice the agent. Notice the agent is notice the principal. You are commanded to give me a certified copy of your foreign agent registration act statement and your certified copy of your anti-bribery statement.
As well as your bond. As well as your bond. It's lime.
Everyone has a claim on the bond. Except for me.
It's lime. It's lime. No, put the ships out there.
Okay.
Because we're going to have people drifting.
So all the ships over here?
Mm-hmm.
All three.
Yeah, but space them out because they running for the car. They running for the salvage.
Mm-hmm. They got to race them.
Mm-hmm. Racing. We just looking for our people. That's what the Moroccan ship out there. Looking for the lost cargo, which is their heirs and their ancestors. Mm-hmm. What's this? You want me to bring that up?
No, you
can't. Why? Oh, look at him. Okay.
Read dimension.
Put ours in the water.
Put ours in the water.
Yeah, like right there. Well, right, you know that's okay.
He went under.
It's not under the water. Go ahead, yeah, just put it
yeah,
in front.
You can have a submarine. Why not?
Mm. Submarine. Oh,
that is funny.
You want them labeled?
Of course. Well, the big one behind got to be the Moroccan boat. So
this one.
That's yeah, that's us. The little one could be the USA boat. Well, Russia can't, USA can't be bigger than Russia.
Why not? Does it really matter?
Make it Germany.
Germany,
really small. It's probably not even as big as Pennsylvania.
You gonna change your name? Yeah, take your proclamation over.
Now put some dead bodies, not dead bodies, I'm sorry. Put some people in the water. I love that drawing. And you know you gotta put our Moroccan flag up.
Tahereh. Yeah. Just stick people, baby.
Stick people.
Oh, right. He trying to put big old bit.
Yeah, just stick people.
Really? Really? Look at you. Look at the people.
Stick people.
Stick people. There you go.
Like an arm. There you go. I would float you. Like an arm.
That's so funny.
God bodies.
Now see where to lead it.
All right, we want
the Moroccan flag. Put that Moroccan flag up because we gotta realize the flags is the passport. The flags are the passport. You don't need an actual card that says passport. Passport. To have a passport is to be dead. Because only cargo property needs a passport. So when you're drifting out in sea, your flag is how people identify you on the seas. And if any of these individuals come up to you, right? This is a passport. We don't need it. Come on, y'all. We own the seas. Mm-hmm. All right? But if any of these other nations, let's say if we had Russia, if we put all the different boats out here, right? Depending on the dominions of the so-called sea, would be who has superiority. So, like, if the Moroccan ship out here, all these other ships got to cater to this one. Because this is the sovereign ship. All right? It's the ship, right? So, this one, it can only be out there if it has this. And you know what it looked like with all those.
Yeah.
You know what that looked like. Yeah. If they ain't got that, they gonna get boarded and confiscated. Because this is their passport. Mm. And it's tied. Commerce. Declaration of Independence. What's the other one? Treaty. Linking them to that. It's linked to that. Constitution.
This is all the public side.
Right? So, and you got a little ambiance on here. Happy. Yay! Got a treaty. I got a treaty and I got the Declaration of Independence. I can be out here and don't got to worry about being boarded as salvage. Because that was what's happening before they had this. Before they had the flag. Right? 9 times out of 10, they got, I don't know what the Germany flag is, so whatever. I don't know what it is. But they got a flag and they got some type of treaty relations too. To be out in that sea. And if they don't have treaty relationships to be out in that sea, guess what? He might launch some stuff and just knock them off. Or he might go boarded. And be like, what you doing out here? Are you what's the word I'm looking for? Are you having some malfunctions? You drifted here? And then if you have treaty relationships through the United Nations, you'll normally tow him back where he belong. So you're gonna tow him. Or you're gonna let him dock. Or you're gonna let him dock, fix his boat, provide him with repairs or stuff that he might need because you got a treaty relation, and send him on his way.
Yes, sure.
Islam? This is dependent upon Morocco. Outside of that, they ain't got none of this. And right now, they ain't got none of that. They ain't even got this. They drifting. Hoping they know something another nation may need to give them some type of treaty relationship somewhere else. Right? So now, because Morocco, this is kind of the state right now at Morocco with these foreigners. They're on their ship trying to claim cargo. And if these people are dead in the eyes of the law, and they get claimed, well, shucks, we just come and claim them and take our people off the ship. And the question is, when they get on the ship, are they going to be fighting us when we come and try to save them? Which is kind of what they're doing right now. The Asiatics that was dead out to sea because they was identifying as Negro colored and black. They now drifting. Being hypothecated by the Albions, and then the Albions are trying to act like they don't recognize the one that gave them the so-called flag, and because they don't recognize, we done took the flag. I mean, I'm sorry, the banner. We done took it. It's gone. So now they drifting. That's what they're literally doing right now, drifting. We over here, chilling. We're like, look, we got supreme laws. You want to get off that, you want to be salvaged, because right now you're drifting. We got the supreme law. You know what the supreme law is. What's the supreme law? Treaty of Peace and Friendship. Constitution for the United States of America. Declaration of Independence, Articles of Confederation, as well as every lawful affidavit and writ signed, sealed by the sovereigns of the land, which is the Moorish American nationals in their proper person, which has not been rebutted, so it stands as law. All that, you gotta follow. All that. You understand what I'm saying? And then Germany out there catching fish. Because they probably was like, oh, can we come out here and catch some fish? And we said, yeah, you can come out and catch some fish, but make sure that's all you're catching. That's the stuff we would say. I'm serious. But 9 times out of 10, we got a treaty. But more than that, they had their own water, so they wouldn't even be here. They got their own water. They got their own dominions. So they wouldn't even be here. So the only ones drifting on our is them. Because everybody else has a status for why they're here. To partake in commerce. So we might have, you know, but right now, because the Albions is sitting here kind of man in the sea, they kind of stuck in specific areas because the Russians won't let them out, the Manchurians won't let them out, but they sitting out there waiting for them. You better leave those Moors alone and give them back their stuff. Mm-hmm. So right now they sitting here like, well, what the hell? They gonna keep playing. Gonna keep playing until the Moors stop drifting. Why y'all still drifting? Y'all got a boat, y'all just not gonna swim to it. And the reality is it's on its way. It's gonna move that Albion boat out the way. It might tow that boat to the land. We might tow it to the land and be like, okay, where's your papers? Where's your papers? I don't have no papers. Well, where are you from? Ireland. I'm from Ireland. I'm from Scottish. I'm from, now all of a sudden everybody wants to say where they from. Well, why are you on this boat, unidentified? They have to have something to identify them because they severed the connection that they had to the Moroccans because they acting like they don't know who we are and they gang warring with us and they warring with us on our land while we peacefully telling you, okay, we forgot who we was, but today we remember, give us back our stuff. Or how about this? Don't get in the way when we claim things. And when we come into an establishment and we have our nationality identification card, which is the superior identification because it's AA222141, absence of a nationality identification card, can you use those corporate cards? Absent of a nationality identification card. So when I come into your establishment, I got nationality identification card, I'm not paying no Federal Reserve notes, I'm not giving you anything. You're dry docked on my land. Do y'all get what I'm saying? So right now, they ain't got no flag. They ain't got nothing. But they still acting like they somebody. Because so many of our people still swimming like, I'm just going to swim out here till we see what boat sinks. Really? That one ain't sinking. That one sunk. It's already down here. It already sunk. It's already sunk. You ain't got no choice but to swim to the Moroccan, to your brothers and sisters who's sitting there trying to catch you. Are we ready to get to property possession now? Because we know clearly what status is. Are we done with status? I ain't doing another video. And Mom, I already told you yesterday, you had the baby. Mom, I should have made let you, you draw Mommy. I should have let you draw Mommy. I don't know what I'm doing. Mom, when you birthed that baby, you birthed him with a dead status. It is your responsibility. I ain't going to use that word. It is your fiduciary duty. I don't even know if that one was a good word to use. To fix what you broke. You gotta fix that. It's like you birthed a dead baby. It's like you birthed a dead baby that's walking around not realizing they dead. Sitting here thinking that they have arrived. Employees with JOBs in these corporations sitting here talking about, what's this? What's this? My nationality identification card? Well, it's not part of the ones that is approved by the policies and procedures of the Federal Bureau of Investigation. And if you don't have a corporate card, you can't get into the building. Mm-hmm. Do you know where you are? I'm in the United States of America. You see the dilemma? You see the pawns at the gate, which are your brothers and your sisters? You see why you lean them? You see why? They gang war with you, but mommy started that because she made them dead, sent them to the educational system, gave them ward cards, took them to a hospital to be pumped with vaccinations that's dumbing them down, giving them bad food, might be giving them good food, might. She did all this stuff to her children and throw them out to the world to go get JOBs. And so whenever they interact with their brothers and sisters who sit here trying to save them, they acting like they don't know who you are. I don't believe that. You have the right to believe what you want to believe. I'm a law-abiding citizen. What's wrong? What's wrong here? Mom, you birthed them. You are responsible. You have an obligation to tell them that they have a status, descendability. They have a nationality. So why is it that Sharon Tracy Gale Bay getting calls from mothers where their sons are in POW camps and they've declared and proclaimed their nationality, but she's sitting here like, I ain't no more. What? Do you realize they get that from you? And you sit here calling me, well, I don't know anything about anything. Well, maybe you should pick up a book and turn off the remote control. So, Mom, fix the sin you placed your heirs in. You placed them in that. But sons and daughters, if your mom ain't going to do it for yourself. Don't wait for her. Just protect everything you can do. And if sons, you had a child, or you fathered a child with an unconscious moor, declare and proclaim nationality for your babies. You got international protections telling you that you can do that. She is under the dead status. She can't complain to nobody. But yet she uses all of the stuff she learned in this infrastructure to violate moors all over the place. We do it through all of the so-called systems that we go to them for support when you own all the land and all you have to do is go and acquire it back, but first correct the dead status you put your babies in because they swimming out here. So has anybody and read the United Nations Declarations on the Rights of the Indigenous People? I read a lot of it for you the other day. A lot of it. Can't no corporation, which don't even have a status, they all out here floating too. They all out here floating trying to say, oh, we have jurisdiction. Well, just because you have this belief and we have this belief, well, how do you think your so-called belief, ours is law, in fact, yours is belief, how you think you gonna win in this? And because they've been doing it for 100 years, they think that's justification and known enough to continue to do it. I'm currently dealing with corporations that are trying to have jurisdiction over my heirs. Mm. My heirs who have international global protections through the hypothecation and the human trafficking of children. Through those things, which is why they sit here like, look, y'all got the right to a nationality. Can y'all please stop floating out here in the damn sea? So people can stop claiming your babies as cargo, salvageable, because you had them with a dead status, but my heirs ain't dead. I have jurisdiction over them. I'm not worried. But then when you have other tribal members, i.e. family members, sitting here going to those Roman venues, You don't think you should be leading them? Mm. They're violating chapter 25 in your culture and your heritage, human trafficking your children. Through this so-called dead status, through this so-called educational system as wards, through a hospital getting pumped up with medications. And you think you're not warring against your own people? And you shouldn't be leaned? All wards that's dealing with that. You better lean your darn family members because of that. They'll get it, or they won't. None of this to say anybody floating is dangerous to you. Regardless of how much you love them. They got to fix it. You can't even fix it for them. But you can sit here and fix it for all your heirs. And make sure you good. It's a new day, y'all. Indigenous people and individuals have the right to belong to an indigenous community or nation. Indigenous people shall not be forcibly removed from their lands or territories. They can't evict you from your own land. They can't force you to pay bills for your own resources. Indigenous people have the right to practice and revitalize their culture, tradition, and customs. Indigenous people have the right to manifest, practice, develop, and teach their spiritual and religious traditions, customs, and ceremonies, the right to maintain, protect, and have access and privacy to their religious and cultural sites. Indigenous people have the right to establish and control their educational systems and institutions providing education in their own language. All law points to you having the right to self-determination however you see fit as the sovereigns of the land. But the first thing you must fix is your debt status. And stop warring with your people who all share the same mother and father. Mother. Mm-hmm. Who has started the possession property? Since we ain't all in it is, we're not dead. We're Moors, we're standing up. We've corrected our status. We did grid one, grid two. Because you at the very least got to do grid one, grid two before you do any land possession. And what is grid one and what is grid two? Grid one is nationality. Grid two is establishment of your Moorish private trust. That's grid one and grid two. So we there. We made it. I ain't going back to status. I don't care who asked me to do it. It's freaking hot, man. I'm burning up.
You got an air conditioner in the car.
Woo! What did you say?
We have an air conditioner in the car.
What about us?
Got that fan back at your work?
Who's hot, huh?
Fan in back of
your
that's room. A fan? Oh, good. That's a
heat. That's
a fan. Is it on?
It's an ion, right?
Turn it on.
Woo! So I'm over here
in
hot flashes.
You having hot flashes too?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's
what
it is. Man, I'm
going to
sit right here for
a while. Woo! Pigs might blow. Looking strong.
Oh, man. Come on, Dad. Get up and talk for 5 minutes.
There was a bear and a rabbit in the woods.
There was a who?
A bear and a rabbit in the woods.
There was a bear and a rabbit in the woods?
Uh-huh.
It's freaking hot, man. If I'm hot, I can just imagine. Why is this? If I'm hot, I can just imagine. So possession property. I am hot. You can just see the hotness in the video. And it's, I forgot I'm still on. Possession. Property possession. Now I know people were caught. The first thing you need to establish is what property to claim. So you gotta first know the property, right? Mm-hmm. So is it the current, is it currently the domicile you're, the property you're domiciling? Could be a property down the street in another corporate territory, could be anything. Only you'll know what property to claim. I suggest you claim something that is comfortable. I would look at the environment. I would look at the area. You know what I'm saying? Don't worry about who's there. I wouldn't. I'm just saying. I'd be wherever I want to be because all communities are yours. Every last one. No matter how many Asiatics are there or Albions that are there. They're all your communities. All of them. So, what? Oh,
you're talking about what property to claim.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So the first thing is what property to claim. So once you found out what property to claim, you got to look and see who is claiming ownership. And let me tell you, if they're not a Moorish American national and got a title, don't matter who the hell is in that system. They can't claim it. They in this status. They like those people that were swimming out in the sea, sitting here acting like they got cars and stuff. They swimming. Who, what corporation is claiming ownership? Where do you find this information? Where do you find the information as to who is claiming the property?
Recorder of deeds.
Recorder of deeds.
Tax assessor.
Tax assessor. I'm going to write that down. When you go there, they're going to sit here and give you at least probably four or five different of the latest people or corporations that are claiming it. So, after you found the property, you found out who's so-called claiming the property through the recorder of deeds of the so-called county corporation. Let me write that down. The next step is what? Write the title. So you're going to create the title. Let me see what we got here. The so-called property and the recorder, and then you go to the recorder of deeds for that information. You want to create and draft the title. The templates for all of these documents are in the file section of the group, or you can get it emailed to you. Y'all should know my email address right now. I don't feel like putting it on the board. Y'all should know it. It's moorishamericanconsulatene@gmail.com, or you can contact Light Tajiri Bay, or you can contact Amor Bay, or you can contact Tariq Bay, or you can contact Jiramore, or you can contact Darians, or you can contact Demetrius. There's a multitude of consoles, leads, post heads, and viziers you can contact if you can't find the information that you need. But most of all, if not all of the documents are located in the file section of the Moorish American Consulate NE Amexum group in Facebook, as well as a lot of these documents, the lawful documents to be recorded and filed with your lawful possession process are inscribed under Sharon Tracy Galvay, then uploaded them all. And I shared them in the groups, and I shared them on my page, the links. And I'm going to put up a new document recording report, which is going to have them all listed with their links so you can go find them and get them yourself outside of the so-called Facebook platform, because they're not just there. They're on the global public notice, which is scribd. All right. So after you create the title, that's one, because that is you claiming the property. That title supersedes any so-called deeds, because deeds are issued through that so-called corporation, and they be issuing them to corporations, which can't claim or own anything. So the first thing is that, and then the next thing is the document called affidavit of allodial, secured land property repossession written statement. You're going to fill that out. So you got one, the title, two, the allodial affidavit of secure land property repossession written title. Now within that document, you're going to list who's claiming, as the two person is the person claiming to be owner of the property. It's most likely going to be a corporation, like a LLC, real estate, something like that. And you're going to go to their website and find out who the leadership team of that corporation is and list the so-called president or the CEO or the so-called owner. Islam? Of the individual claiming ownership. You're going to also do a affidavit of UCC-1 leaning that corporation claiming ownership. Because corporations can't own anything at Morocco. So you're going to lien them. You're going to create the title. You're going to create the allodial, the affidavit of allodial secured land property repossession written statement. You're going to file or process the affidavit of UCC-1 lien, that which is the corporation claiming ownership. And you're getting that from the recorder of deeds or the tax assessors of the so-called county, the website. All you're going to need is the so-called numbering, that numbering system that they have on the so-called property, as well as the so-called street address. Realize that that is a corporation in and of itself. The mailing, so-called residential location, is a corporation. You're leaning that as well. I would title my domicile under your trust. Yeah. So whatever the so-called title of your trust, I'm not using names, I'm using titles. Whatever you title your trust, title your property that way, that too. My property, which is X-Rail, 36 North Harwood, X-Rail, because I lean that, I lean the so-called corporation claiming ownership, and I lean, and I retitled it 1111 Yesharim Moabite Moorish Estate. That is what it's titled as. Okay? So you have to X-rel those. So put your title above in the brackets underneath, put X-rel whatever the street address, was prior to you leaning it and titling it. Okay? And make sure you put the latitude, longitude, geographical location as well to enhance them knowing exactly what you are claiming. Islam? This affidavit of allodial land property repossession written statement is for notification purposes of our ecclesiastical repossession of our said property. The Moorish National Republic Federal Government has already repossessed possessed land and property as the Moors at North Central South America, the adjoining islands, and the Western Hemisphere, and all land as mandated by our ancient Aboriginal Theronic ancestors pursuant to the Treaty of Peace and Friendship 1786 and 1836 and the Constitution for the United States of America 1791. We have a religious right to our ancient ancestral lands as part and parcel of our worship. So then you sign, you put your appellation on there, you put your current mailing location on there in proper, lawful way of stating it, care of, near, and then you complete the document. And it's self-explanatory. The debtor is the so-called owner claiming ownership. That's the debtor. You put the latitude, longitude coordinates on there so they know exactly what it is, because that so-called corporate address does not identify land because it's corporate. Then you sign and seal it. Then your affidavit of allodial, secured land, property, repossession, written statement is completed. Thank you. So with that, you created your title. You created your allodial, your affidavit of allodial, secured land, property, repossession, written statement. You've leaned the corporation claim and ownership. You've leaned the corporate address. Now you're going to send that out with supporting documentation.
Go ahead.
Put down the parcel number as well.
If you want to put the parcel number down, I would bracket it. So once you complete those documents, you're going to send copies to the following, and you're going to record your title along with your affidavit of allodial, secure property, prepossession, written statement, and the recorder of deeds of the so-called county. So it's on the public record. If you already have a council script uploaded, give it a record number. If you don't have record numbers, just call me and I'll give you one, or text me like, Sharon, I need a record number for my affidavit, da, da, da. And then I'll send you, here it is, and I'll send it to you. And then once you've finished and you've signed and sealed it up and you scanned it back into your system, your computer system, save it under MACN-R, whatever the number is, and then call it affidavit of allodial, secured land, property, repossession, written statement with all supporting documentation. And then upload it to Scrib and upload it to the file section of the group. Public notification. And then you're going to mail it, certified return receipt, to the person claiming ownership or the corporation claiming ownership, the sheriff of that particular county, the county recorder, but that's where you're going to record it with the deed, so that's the recorder of deeds, the governor general, the U.S. and state attorney general, the U.S. Department of State, the Secretary of State, the mayor, and the policy enforcer department that is doing business near you. And you're giving them notification. Notification that you have put out your due process to lawfully claim your estate. And you're giving the hypothecators claiming under the corporate jurisdiction to be owner a 3-day to rebut your claim. They won't do this because they can't. They're corporations. They don't own anything. They're mad that you found out. And now the same thing that they did to hypothecate your stuff, you're going to do to reclaim it. But you're giving them notifications in case they want to try to rebut. Any rebuts that you get from a so-called attorney, office, or anybody, lean them. You have to lean everybody because they're violating you. Mm-hmm. They don't own anything. They don't have any authority here. Attorneys are just like the cashier at Walmart or Starbucks. They have no... A presumed, as well as the so-called administrators claiming to be judges, they're magis. They're liars. They're actors. Because if you don't have the delegation of authority from the sovereigns of the land, you're acting in a capacity that nobody gave you to do so. and you should lean them just because of that. All right. Once you've done that, once you've sent it all out to all those individuals, right? And you've recorded it, 3 days later, you're going to send out a the supporting documentation. Where's the supporting documentation? The supporting documentation that you're going to send with it is the Universal Religious Corporation affidavit. Now, keep in mind, there's a document record report that has them tracking information for those documents. So if you don't feel like looking for them in the file section, because there's a lot of files, they are referenced by those record numbers. So if you just put that in Google, it's already loaded on Scrib. So you'll be able to download it from Scrib quick and easy, as long as you have an account. I have an account with Scrib. Ben had an account with Scrib because that's where I received a lot of my Moorish documents prior to, you know, people having, they had the Clock of Destiny and different things like that for your, you know, as well as other things they had. They have a lot of stuff in Scrib. So if you don't have an account with Scrib, I would get it, because that's, we're pushing everything out on that global platform. Affidavit of termination of trusteeship. Affidavit of corporate death penalty. And corporate death penalty. What is a death penalty? Your corporation is now dead because we UCC 1 leaned it and took it out of operation. That's what a corporate death is. Private trust declaration showing the property is in the trust. So you might have to reword some of your trust to include the properties you're claiming. Okay?
What if it's already sealed?
Doesn't matter, redo it.
Okay.
It's a separate sheet.
Yeah. I understand it's a separate sheet, but when you add something to it, it moves all the paperwork around and then the seal's no longer there.
Let's get it resealed.
Okay.
I mean, you could have bought it, if you would have did it yesterday, you could have had it here and got it sealed today. I'm just saying.
It's done.
It's done?
It's just not here.
Oh.
It's on the table. That's what I was looking for.
I know, it's these papers be looking alike, don't they?
Yes, they do.
I know, you got it. The allodial land title for the property, which is this, create the title. The affidavit of cancellation and abolishment of all land patents. Certified copy of the express trust, the 1010-5905, our authority terms. And you know what that is. That's the trust of the property.
Yes, it is.
After they have not rebutted nor disputed the affidavit within 3 days, create a default notice stating that they have defaulted on the affidavit and create an affidavit of non-response. The default notice, I created a default notice / non-response notification all in one document.
Mm-hmm.
Where all you're sitting here saying is, look, you had 3 days to rebut this claim. You didn't rebut this claim. Here is the verification that you received it through the tracking. So you're going to have to go to the website USPS, put in all the tracking numbers, print out the delivery date confirmation sheets. Add that to that non-response document.
Mm.
Send it in a letter format. I wouldn't certify it. You don't have to. Put it on the public forum. Give it a record number and put it out there on the globe, which is under Scrib. All right?
2 hours.
What was that?
It was
oh.
My phone.
How do you spell Scrib? S-C-R-I-B-D?
S-C-R-I-B-D.
B-D?
Mm-hmm. Now, some people want to prepare a statement for the newspaper to run it in 30 days. You can do that if you choose. Putting it on Facebook, putting it on Scrib is so way better than putting it in the local newspaper. I just hope you know that. Because Scrib is global.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want to do that in addition, do it. If you feel like it. If you want to do that for the next property, for whatever property that you don't domicile in, if it's a property down the street that you really, really like, do it. Why not? Can't nobody for a future claim?
Mm-hmm.
They can't do it.
Sure
they can. They can't. That's why they mad. And that's why they sit here calling you sovereign citizens. And that's why they sitting here unlawfully detaining Moorish American nationals all over the land, because they know Moorish American nationals can't grab land lawfully. Nobody else can do it, which is why they're messing with you.
We're not pirates or vandals.
Nope. We are peaceful inhabitants of our Moroccan soil, correcting the wrong, correcting the hypothecation, fixing what's going on here.
Yeah.
We are peaceful, and we will not be bullied. We will not be threatened. We will not be I don't even know what the other word is, but we are not going to be stopped from claiming our land. We already are getting international aid to assist us in getting you to get back in your subject place. Automatic. It's already on its way. I suggest you stop acting like you have a standing. I suggest it. I'm just saying. Because, what was it? Somebody read Jeremiah 11:11. If you can find it. Once the 3 days have passed and the newspaper statement notice has not been rebutted nor disputed, then create, okay, we already talked about the non-response. Okay, after you have completed this process and that time frame has passed, you're going to take those documents along with the Aboriginal Indigenous writ of possession by command of the Moorish National Republic Federal Government and the Moorish American Consulate to the sheriff. I wouldn't go to any deputies. Go to the sheriff. Because you don't know who's been deputized. You don't know who else has the authority. And the so-called sheriff, the one in charge, the one that is supposed to be elected, and the one that is supposed to have taken an oath to the Constitution, is the one that is supposed to be, you're only going there to let them know you're going into your property, and when you're going in there. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And letting them know, the shepherd said, right?
Yes.
We lean.
You lean them because they're supposed to do their J-O-P. Okay. That's why you lean them. If they don't, what's that? No, no. That's me? It's called. Now, who is the sheriff responsible to protect? Who is us?
The Moors, the nobles, the Moorish American Nationals.
The Nationals, right? The Moorish American Nationals, the people. They have an oath to do what we tell them, command them to do. And I'm talking about the sheriff. I ain't talking about everybody else that thinks they're underneath the sheriff. I'm talking about the individual that so-called got elected to and took an oath to the Constitution for the United States of America. They sign. If they give you resistance, they have already dissolved themselves of that position by not signing. You command them to sign. You command it. And if that particular one wants to be belligerent, put it on a public forum that you gave them their responsibility and they failed on that, and they are no longer in that capacity. They've dissolved themselves of that responsibility by not doing their or following their oath, and you go to another county that is doing it. And tell them go arrest that sheriff. Or go arrest that individual acting as a sheriff, but not following his oath and his duty. Nonetheless, you have every lawful position to support and go into the property you have just now claimed lawfully and given everybody due process to stand down. So if I were you, and I already have done this, the sheriff would be leaned already. The person claiming ownership of the property would be leaned on it already. The county recorder would already be leaned. The Governor General would already be leaned. The U.S. Attorney General would already be leaned. The Secretary of State would already be leaned. The Mayor would already be leaned. And the policy enforcer that domiciles within that territory would already be leaned. And why are we leaning them? It's to either correct your behavior and follow the law and defend and support the Nationals, or you no longer have that responsibility. Because guess what? They're going to start doing what you tell them to do because they have those liens on them. And like I said, they swimming out to sea. They swimming out to sea, y'all. And Morocco or any other Nationals could pick their asses up. I'm just saying. So they can continue to be belligerent, but we're getting international aid right now to help to aid us in getting the belligerent warmongers off our lands. And that's coming. It's already here. Anybody got any questions? Next week, we're going to have at least the first part of that done. You ain't going to try. You're going to manifest.
Next week.
The other dude was here last week. He said,
I got a second property I'm looking at. I got a second one already. I'm ready to go start. Huh? Oh, yeah. I got a whole township.
Go ahead, girl.
Where I'm going to move everybody out, and it's going to be my little Moorish sanctuary. Y'all all gonna have a house there. Just tell them. Ain't nobody gonna be there that ain't declared, proclaimed. Just saying. It got hotels in there. It has everything. So when people come from different, because I'm claiming a domicile, a couple in a bunch of places, because I don't plan on just being here.
Exactly.
I'm gonna be all over the place.
Navigating
all over the place. I'm gonna be down in the corporate territory of New Jersey, the corporate territory of Delaware, the corporate territory of Seattle, Washington, to go see my girl Light. I'm going to be down in Canaan land. I'm going to be down in North Carolina corporate district. I'm going to be down in Colorado. I'm going to be down in Texas, claiming a house in every area, because I'm going to be in all those areas at different times of the year, because in the so-called winter, I ain't going to be here. I'm going to probably be down in Khalifa territory with my girl Kim. I'm just being real. Me and my heirs are going to be all over the place.
That's right.
Not going to be just here. So, anybody got any questions? That's a better question. We'll leave the last couple of minutes because we ain't have to nationalize nobody today. I can't see that.
You didn't give me anything. Let
me see if anybody asked a question. It is so hot, y'all.
Can I see them?
Oh, dying.
Can you hear me? Just keep them.
And we ain't got to be rushing. Awesome sauce.
Keep them.
Keep them what?
It's hot. Those documents.
Come off the consular website for the review session.
Somebody would say I need the email address.
Actually,
I'm going to put it on here.
Huh?
I don't feel
like
it.
You can keep that.
It's hot. Look at me. I'm like, y'all didn't tell me I was shining. Like a milk. I'm going crazy. Hot, glowing. I'm burning up. So we are going to end with the mantra. Who else going to say the mantra? Is anybody going to say the mantra?
I'm not.
You want me to write it on the board? I'll do that. No, I'm going to.
Next class.
Pastor, are you going to write on the board? And I said I was going to do this too.
It's camera shot.
We got a list. The Moors that are currently being detained in the POW camps unlawfully.
Yes.
Oh, no. Oh, really? You really not going to write on me? Do I got another one? Huh? Red Papier's Corpus is for Moors.
They did. What?
No.
Told him.
We be acting like we Moors. Stay good.
That's my consort, DeCorey Christopher Pitts L. He is still being unlawfully detained at George W. Hill Correctional Facility, located in the corporate territory of Thornton, Pennsylvania Corporation. DeCorey Christopher Pitts L. Nora. He's a consul, commissioned of the Moorish American Consulate. Nora. She has a long appellation, y'all. Does anybody know her long appellation? What's Nora's long appellation? Because I want to put the whole appellation there. And there's a list of so many other Moors that we need to have this done. We need to constantly be putting up The Moors that are unlawfully being detained at the POW camps, the prisoner of war corporations, because they need to be lean. George W. Hill Correctional Facility has already been lean. As well as every hypothecator that claimed he is a nom de guerre, holding him under a war name. Anybody know the appellation of Nora? Can somebody tell me where her full appellation is so I can put it on a public record?
We'll pull it up. It's on the consulate website.
Anybody know it? What's Nora's full appellation?
Consulate website.
You gonna fight me? Why don't you just look it up?
I'm sure.
Well, hurry up. I'm like, ooh. How come every time, there it is, .org. What's that?
Who is this? Why do you keep sending me stuff?
Who's hot? There she is.
There she is. Mm-hmm. Well, this one, I got an email, but yeah, these are all the property repossession notes right here.
That's Nora Bay. Who else? Who else being unlawfully detained in the POWs?
It's a young noble from
got a lot
Texas.
Of them, y'all.
He knows the natural,
I can't be the only one that knows them. Appalachians. I need Appalachians.
Sea
Cannon Bay is being detained?
Mm-hmm.
Sea Cannon Bay?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? How you spell Cannon? Am I spelling it?
C-A-N-N-O-N.
Who else? It's being unlawfully detained. We need a complete list next week. Next week, I want a complete list of all the Moors being unlawfully detained. One of the consuls will be responsible for that. You want to be responsible for that, Fatima? Is that why you're holding your hand up?
No. I was handing you this.
You were handing me something? What you handing me? What's this?
For my daughter-in-law.
Oh, okay. So who's it? Don't let me appoint. Am I appointing someone, Anab? Tahir? Fatima?
Okay, I'll do it.
You want to do
it?
So you're going to next week or during the week give us a completed list, Islam. Give us a completed list of Moorish American nationals being unlawfully detained.
Yes,
and when anybody is being detained, can we push those emails and calls to you so you can log them? Oh, I love when...
Yes, I love
it. Don't get me to start it. Because you don't know those calls will start coming. Coming. So Fatima is going to be the consul who's commissioned to keep track of all the Moorish American nationals, including with Tahir. I know he'll help her consorts. So we have a complete list of the Moorish American nationals, and I will be able to write all of them down, as well as facilities they're being listed, they're being held at, and what nom de guerre war name they're being held under. Islam? So let's put the mantra up, and then we're going to say, Arrivederci. So as of right now, I know there's a list of names. Rodney's one of them, Rodney Bay. I don't like putting people's half appellations down. I like having their full appellations, but Rodney Bay is being detained. Another Moor contacted me. So many Moors contacted me, and I got to write. When they contact me, I highlight it on the database, so I have a running total. I don't have my laptop, as you know. The Federal Bureau of Investigations under so-called Michael Donahue, who's saying that they have it, but yet he has not produced the so-called warrant as of yet, stating who at the so-called Federal Bureau of Investigations located in the Corporate District of Philadelphia has my electronical devices. He's already leaned. They're already leaned. I have every expectation that my items will return to me as they were taken from me. Islam? Anybody see that article? That public article where the so-called Federal Bureau of Investigations admitted that. Anybody saw that? Talking about the so-called black extremist groups?
Yes.
Did y'all see that?
Yeah.
What was they talking about?
She was expressing that...
They made it up, maybe?
They made it up. Yeah, they admitted they made it up.
It was that
the policy enforcers were in fear of black intelligent extremists, and the Federal Bureau's investigations were saying that those were frivolous claims against the policy enforcers.
To do what? To try to sit here and profile the Moors,
right.
Profile us as being these hateful people when all we're doing is sending lawful, peaceful documents, claiming our state.
Where is she?
She questioned two of them as well. A yes or no answer. Do you see the so-called BIE or Black Intelligence Extremists as terrorists?
They've been messing with the files on the Facebook group.
Who?
Somebody. I guess the FBI, because it's coming up as
what's coming up?
To open document. File appears to be corrupt.
What file?
The affidavit of repossession, I guess.
Somebody else tried to open up. It could be his phone.
It could
be bugging him.
Yeah.
And I'm going to put the mantra up. Write it down, Moors.
A lot of files don't open up on the phone.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I got it. I'm not.
Yeah.
You got it? No, I know how, you know.
He's trying to do it. The old part. The old ones.
I want to know why I'm writing this down.
Because you're the best.
Wow. Whatever. like Moore's case, you didn't know he was pregnant. Oh man, can y'all read that? The only thing missing is notice the agent, notice the principal, notice the principal, notice the agent. And then I liked what Tahir added. Mm-hmm. Which he'll write after that dream.
He runs me crazy. What did he
say? Empress, when you get the flag,
so. That's his flag. Mm-hmm. Where'd you get the flag?
Where'd you get the flag?
Probably in the city.
Oh, you got a pen?
Oh, okay.
Where you get the pen from?
Yeah, the flag shop.
Say
it. Oh, goodness.
Flag ship.
What, you
talking about
New York?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Need
that.
Are you able to order that online?
Freaking hot, man.
You can probably get one online, but you got to be careful. Make sure that the stars are correct.
That's right.
There's a lot of what they term as the Moroccan flag. It's like different than what they do.
Okay.
Even though we had to order flags.
Mm-hmm.
Islam, right?
I'm trying to get some.
What's my school say?
That hurt my hand.
We did good. Man, nobody come in here to do that. I just got to get stuff finished. I got to write down who's here that I need to do theirs. So it's not,
Oh, back hurt.
Y'all familiar with the Dance Africa?
Dance Africa.
Mm-hmm. That band, Brooklyn Academy of Music.
Where?
Brooklyn Academy of Music.
No.
You know where the clock is, right? Down from
uh-huh.
Brooklyn?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's a festival there, like they call Memorial Day weekend.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a big event, like 3 days.
Eastern Parkway?
Mm-hmm. Another Labor Day, this is Memorial Day, so this coming weekend is going to be there. It's a big event of the year, like 40 years going on.
Okay.
A lot of food vendors and stuff. Mm-hmm.
Good afternoon, the time is now 4:37 and the library will be closing soon at 5 o'clock. Please be advised that all public computers will automatically shut down 10 minutes before 5.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Robin. I mean, because it's good, you know, there's a lot of people out and stuff.
Right.
So I see a lot of people in the middle of the way.
That's on a Saturday, or 3 days.
It's 3 days, Saturday.
Oh.
And then the African Arts Festival is like the 4th of July.
Mm-hmm.
And then it goes. There's another big event. People from all over the world.
I was actually trying to catch the Harlem Renaissance. They still have that?
Probably so. This
everybody finished writing down?
One last one.
You want me to go get the children? I mean, you might get screwed. I want to get them, but you know, I'd be stealing them from him.
Is there anything else after the second trip?
Okay.
Where are you in?
I'm just saying, because you know, I don't want to.
take them back. I don't want to give them until I have to take them back. Meaning, once I get back in my dorm, so then I'll be there. Yeah. I'm saying, if I don't see them today. Matter of fact, where's my phone? You gonna go write up the your portion that was added? That you added? I like what you added to the to mantra.
Yeah, maybe race.
Race only, because they should be done, right? Everybody should be almost done. You finished? Really? You wasn't. I'll help you with the rest. You can just scroll right there.
Yeah,
oh, what
I
gotta do
with
these?
Seal
them.
That's it?
Mm-hmm.
Sign them,
seal them,
sign. Yeah, just write the top part as much as you need.
So I can give them to
you. Do I have a photo of my mama?
Don't
arm me.
No.
Huh?
I will send you.
Well, that's the one that you were showing me all those pictures last time?
Yeah.
Okay. So we only had one copy? I meant the one original?
Yeah.
You know you're going to have to email me.
Yeah.
That person is calling me as an individual from PLW camp right now, Cole. We don't have a who? What the? What we supposed to be? What?
We don't have a consul.
A con who?
A consul.
You are a consul.
Yeah. We don't have a consul.
Who y'all be talking to?
People that like black people trying to
Yeah, that's what it is.
They ignorant as heck.
Or you're purposely misleading people.
It's they, you know, a lot of, we got a lot of Mariscos out there.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of them.
A lot of agents out there, too.
Agents, yeah.
Everybody's going to have to be under whoever they are in fear of. And if they fear Rome more than they fear their ancestors, it's on them. Did I do yours?
No, it's for me and my daughter.
Oh, send me both. I have those photos.
And
yeah, you have our photos.
I have everything.
So now
I'm going to do all y'all's today.
Yes.
Before it gets lost in sauce.
Don't get my baby.
Huh? What? What'd you say? She talking to me? What's today's date?
19th.
What did you say?
I have my niece at my house, and she's waiting for me to come back so I can tell her that I did all right with my husband driving.
You don't like him traveling? He's a speed demon?
He's just all over the road. Oh, my God. He's everywhere. And I try to keep my cool. Today, because son was traveling with us.
Your son was traveling?
Son.
I mean, you got one and a half. Huh?
Son,
yeah, they're probably out of order.
Huh?
Talking about me, son. So, said I was traveling with them.
He was traveling with us in the car, so I had to mute my mouth. They're probably in there.
You
just all over.
You had an extra.
Yeah.
Scan this to me.
Yes, I
in the email, so I can put it. So I can have it in the record.
Sure.
And then send me a photo when you scan it, so I can put it all together. Her MAC number is 1305, but I'll send you the document. And everybody here that I need to do
IDs for me.
Good afternoon. The time is now 4:45, and the library will be closing in 15 minutes at 5 o'clock. All public computers will automatically shut down in just 5 minutes, so take care of any of your printing needs as soon as you can.
Look, I ain't need none
also
of this
take
stuff.
This time to gather your personal belongings and make any final selections of items you'd like to check out.
Yeah.
We'll reopen
supposed
tomorrow
be noticed
morning
to
at
agent?
10.
Yes.
Principal is noticed. Second line.
Notice to agent.
Notice to principal is notice to agent.
And it's just a notice. Oh, okay. It's just a notice.
It's flip flop. Notice the agent, notice the principal. Notice the principal, notice the agent.
Okay. I'm just going to write your name down.
You mean
Appalachian?
Yes, Appalachian.
Who's hot?
Put that at the top.
But you know, a lot of Moors are using the same appellation, so it could be.
Elvis, your bag.
We got who did?
People don't want us to get out.
I just want to let you guys know the library is closing in 14 minutes.
We are on our way. Thank you.
The birth certificate don't need to be sealed, correct?
Huh?
The Moors birth certificate doesn't need to be sealed.
Moors birth. Oh, you talking about Not necessarily. Like, I mean, it can be.
It can be. Okay. Yeah, I want to see it. Yeah.
So this is everybody?
Yes.
Did she make it?
Robin
make it. I was worried. Fatima, who's Kadar?
My son.
You what?
He
you
paid.
Know.
Oh, shit.
It's been
I might have to send everybody's application so they can redo the seals because I scanned in every nationality order ID that I had in my persons.
You know
I,
what? You know
I scanned
what?
Them all.
It might have been in an old computer.
Could be. It most likely is in my freaking laptop.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm going to, matter of fact,
you took every picture with your phone.
I do have y'all photos.
Yeah.
Now, I know I have y'all photos. I don't know about your photo.
What? I
was looking. That's why I called you this morning. I was trying to get yours done because I did his. And I was like, how come I have his? That's because they did it like a whole month after each other. Because the numbers, I already know.
You were last live.
Us
first. So get it done.
So everybody's going to have to. Everybody got my phone number, right?
Yes.
Everybody in here that's waiting for nationality identification cards.
Yeah.
Y'all have my phone number, right?
Yeah, no.
Huh?
No.
610.
Okay.
803-1170. Send me a text message with your appellation. Tell me you're waiting on nationality identification card.
Okay.
All right? All right. Havertown class.
Okay.
Send a photo so I'll know who I'm talking to.
Okay.
You
I have you in my phone already logged, but that's not a photo for ID.
No.
That wouldn't work. Tahir, can you take her photo for her identification card when you get back home with her?
I sent you a passport photo.
In the mail?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know the hypothecates took on shit.
I know.
Jewels. You know that, right? That's what it is.
What'd you say?
Jewels.
I got a lot of who?
This man, period.
Yeah, that's
thanks.
A lot of jewels.
Who got a lot of jewels?
You should see our library. Yes, I had to. I had to go in the basement and find everything. Like, for real, because when we moved, we just, you know, put all the books in bins and put them in the basement.
It's Lawnmowers. We out. Peace and love.
Now we got